Actually, I missed my stiff arm, so it made it look like I was like leaning on him, which was what I was trying to do. I missed my stiff arm, and I knew he was gonna try to push me out, so I just tried to lean on him and use his momentum to like just drive me to the touchdown. So, but it's also a great block by DP. You know, I waited, set it up, he kicked out, and I just ran right behind him.
Mm. This game by falling behind. It might have been a different game if you guys had started better. How do you get the best effort from both sides of the ball early in the game?
It's just what you said. Just give the best effort, you know what I mean? At the end of the day, we have to start fast. That's what Coach Drink tells us every day. But at the end of the day, as players, we have to do that ourselves too. So I just feel like it's just exactly what you said. We just got to give out our best effort day in and day out.
Well, you've been through, obviously, a couple seasons now. What do you communicate to the team about how to best use a bye week to maximize the rest of the year?
Definitely just take time, you know what I mean? Just get away from football a little bit, you know, just get your mind right. Mental health is a big thing for me, you know what I mean? Meditate and just really just reflect on yourself. And then later on, when we focus on Vanderbilt, just to focus on the game, you know? But at the end of the day, you got to focus on the present moment, you know?
So how do you evaluate your first 7 games or the team's first 7 games?
It's kind of like you can't really go back and think about the past, you know what I mean? I kind of like just wait until we reflect as a whole after the season's over, you know? But it's also things we got to take as a lesson, you know what I mean, and learn from it in the past, of course. But at the end of the day, we got to keep moving forward. We can't really just stay in the past, you know?
Coach Drinkwitz was saying that he felt like a lot of the mistakes were self-inflicted with penalties and turnovers. I guess does that make it a little tougher to swallow?
Of course. No one wants to get out there and get a minus 10. You know what I mean? Like, and no one like intentionally tries to go out there and hold or do something, you know, to hurt the team, you know? So it's just hard trying to bounce back, but we got to be able to fight through adversity and get stuff done.
What do you think you guys can do to kind of be more disciplined and not, you know, get some of those calls?
I just feel like we just need to be more aggressive, you know, just be more confident in ourselves. You know, so I feel like that's just the biggest thing for us, and just keep practicing and practicing hard.
What was the feeling in the locker room, and maybe what was your message to the guys around you?
Just keep moving forward, you know, just be confident in yourself. You know, a lot of people like to get down on themselves, but at the end of the day, it's just a game, you know. I feel like you got to be – it's more stuff to live for, you know what I mean? I'm pretty sure Deion Sanders said that real pressure is a single mother, you know what I mean? Someone that really has to fight. At the end of the day, this is a game, you know what I mean? So you got to think about your future, you know what I mean? And think forward about yourself in a way, and also as a team, you know?
When you guys are down 21-0, how much of it does it take out of your game plan? Maybe you got to take some things out that you want to establish mm-hmm. early on?
Definitely, you know what I mean? When you're down a lot, you know, you got to turn into a passing game, you know? So we're kind of playing catch up, you know, it's kind of hard. And I feel like we just dug ourselves into a hole.
Tyler, it seemed like the run defense from Texas A&M was, you know, really getting to the line early on those plays. What was the most difficult part about facing that type of run defense?
I feel like they didn't do anything too special, you know what I mean? A lot of times they're just bringing zero, you know what I mean? They're coming from the backside, hitting from behind, but I mean, they weren't doing anything special, you know what I mean? It wasn't like they're like a great run defense, you know? So, I mean, at the end of the day, we just had to go back in the drawing board and just look at what we need to do better in the future.
I'm wondering, this team beat Alabama last week. Oh, yeah. I was wondering when they came in, did you see this as a big opportunity for you?
Oh, yeah, for sure, definitely, you know what I mean? Anytime someone can knock off the number one team in the nation, you know what I mean, it's always a good opportunity for everybody else. And at the end of the day, we failed to seize the opportunity. But at the end of the day, we played well against them, and we did good things, and we also did bad things. But we also got to learn from the good things and learn from the bad things as well.
You've seen Connor play better. How's he hanging in there?
Oh, yeah. Definitely. I talked to him after the game. I just tell him keep his head up. You know, at the end of the day, like I said, it's going to be lessons, and it's going to be failures, and it's going to be successes. You know what I mean? That's football. You know what I mean? But at the end of the day, he's our quarterback. He's our leader of this team. He has to be confident, and we have to keep pushing forward. We have to help him as a team and build him up, you know what I mean, and just keep us together. Definitely, you know what I mean? My biggest thing is just staying together, you know what I mean? A lot of times, people that have a lot of successes, you know, it's easy for them to be like, oh yeah, we're winning, you know what I mean? But failures and adversity is just like what makes you a team, you know what I mean? And right now, we're facing a lot of adversities. We just have to stay together and be a better team.
That's your shirt.
No, sir, I am not. I am not, but I try to get involved with that. You know, I got the shirt from Miss Tori, so I didn't know it was really like a hospital thing. I just liked the little message plan for hope. So, yeah, I'll look into it then. I thank you. No, you just said it right. I'm involved in a running pass game, so I don't really have to change what I do. You know what I mean? I just do what I do best. And so if the ball come my way, if I have to pick up a block, I'm going to do whatever I got to do for my team, you know. So at the end of the day, that just helps being versatile, you know what I mean, being able to stay in the game, whether it's a run game or a pass game, you know what I mean. And I feel like my skill set is perfect for it.
Anything else for Tyler? Thank you, sir.
Appreciate y'all.